22 billion years. It'll expanding faster than the fabric of space-time can keep up with it. And it'll just rip. And I'm terrified by this.
The James Webb Space Telescope, a marvel of scientific exploration, has astounded us with its incredible discoveries. But now, it has stumbled upon something that threatens the very essence of our existence. The JWST has discovered an alarming signal in the form of gravitational waves from the luminous star, Betelgeuse. So what does this signal indicate? An imminent explosion or supernova? And what are the potential risks for our planet? Let's find out.
To the edge of the universe, finding galaxies being born, and you could, because it's infrared, it peers through nearby gas clouds. Stars are made of gas. They're made from gas clouds. So when you peer in, you see the stellar nursery that lurks within.
In the vastness of space, there's a star that has captured the attention of astronomers and the public alike. It's called Betelgeuse, and it resides in the constellation of Orion, around 640 light years away from Earth. This colossal star is a staggering 1,400 times larger than our Sun, emitting a brightness that surpasses it by a staggering 14,000-fold. What makes Betelgeuse so fascinating is its resemblance to another famous star called Antares, located in the constellation of Taurus. The similarity in brightness and color between Betelgeuse and Antares has piqued the curiosity of scientists. One of the significant events that have recently caught the attention of astronomers is the great dimming of Betelgeuse. In 2019 and 2020, the star experienced a sudden decrease in brightness, dropping to around 35% of its usual luminosity. This unprecedented dimming puzzled scientists, and numerous explanations were proposed, including the possibility that Betelgeuse was contracting before a potential explosion. The mystery of the Great Dimming was finally unraveled through data collected by the James Webb Telescope and the Japanese weather satellite Himawara 8. Infrared and optical observations revealed that the dimming was caused by a combination of the star cooling and a cloud of dust condensing around it. Recently, gravitational waves were detected at Betelgeuse using ground-based observatories like LIGO, Laser Interferometer Gravitational Wave Observatory, and Virgo, which employ precise interferometer setups to measure subtle changes in the length of laser beams caused by passing gravitational waves. The sensitive instruments and meticulous analysis allowed scientists to capture and verify the signals, providing valuable insights into Betelgeuse's behavior and its potential connection to its future supernova explosion.
It's a stellar nursery, and it's forming not only stars, but planets in orbit around them, exoplanets. And so we now have more than 5,000 exoplanets in the catalog, and this telescope is gonna be among its many abilities. It'll be able to measure the chemistry of the atmosphere of exoplanets that pass in front of their host star.
Now, some scientists are linking the detection of gravitational waves to the star's imminent explosion. According to Salvatore Vitale, a physics professor at MIT who works with the Laser Interferometer Gravitational Wave Observatory, LIGO, the gravitational wave detections from Betelgeuse don't necessarily confirm that the wave is originating from the star itself. Additionally, neutrinos, which are typically released just before a supernova, haven't been detected from Betelgeuse yet. Therefore, the connection between the gravitational wave candidate and the star remains uncertain. The detection of gravitational waves also raises questions about its origin and nature. While the detection is intriguing, it may not necessarily be a gravitational wave, as it doesn't exhibit the characteristics of known mergers. There is still uncertainty about what caused the detection, and it's possible that it could be a result of noise from Earth or other unknown factors. Normally, Betelgeuse experiences dimming every 430 days, with additional periodic dark spots appearing on its surface. But what startled scientists was a different kind of dimming, something unusual for this star. These peculiar observations led them to believe that Betelgeuse is approaching the end of its life cycle, teetering on the precipice of a cataclysmic explosion known as a supernova. Naturally, this revelation has left scientists and astronomers deeply concerned. Detecting gravitational waves from this area has raised questions about the timing and potential impact of Betelgeuse's eventual explosion. Could it happen in the near future? And if so, what repercussions would it have for our universe? As scientists meticulously analyze data from NASA's James Webb Space Telescope and the Hubble Space Telescope, along with other observatories, signs of an imminent blowout in the luminous red supergiant star Betelgeuse become evident. The gravitational waves serve as a significant indicator, revealing that Betelgeuse likely underwent a colossal eruption a couple of years ago, shedding a substantial portion of its visible surface. As a result, it now releases a massive surface mass ejection, hinting at the possibility of an impending explosion. What sets this phenomenon apart is the scale of Betelgeuse's activity. In comparison to a typical coronal mass ejection, where our Sun releases parts of its outer atmosphere, Betelgeuse's explosion expelled a mind-boggling 400 billion times more mass. Such unprecedented behavior has left scientists astounded and perplexed. Despite ongoing observations, scientists are still grappling with the enigmatic nature of these events. Andrea Dupree from the Center for Astrophysics in Cambridge, Massachusetts, acknowledges the perplexity, stating that Betelgeuse continues to exhibit highly unusual behavior, with its interior exhibiting peculiar fluctuations. While scientists navigate this puzzle, they have gleaned valuable insights from the JWST's observations. The massive loss of mass in red stars as they near their demise, resulting from their nuclear fusion furnaces burning out, has become evident. The magnitude of this mass loss plays a pivotal role in their fate. And with Betelgeuse shedding such a significant portion of its components, it raises concerns about an imminent explosion. Further analysis of the collected data revealed a remarkable series of events that had unfolded on Betelgeuse's surface. Astronomers utilized various observatories and instruments, including the JWST, LIGO, the Whipple Observatories, the Hubble Space Telescope, the American Association of Variable Star Observers, and NASA's Solar Terrestrial Relations Observatory spacecraft. The observations indicated that Betelgeuse had experienced a massive surface ejection, an unprecedented phenomenon. This ejection was triggered by a convective plume, a colossal structure stretching over a million miles across the star's surface, bubbling up from deep within its core. The resulting shocks and pulsations violently expelled a substantial chunk of the star's outer layer, known as the photosphere. The consequences of this massive eruption were awe-inspiring. A vast, cool surface area formed beneath the dust cloud generated by the cooling photosphere. The expelled material, in the form of a dust cloud, obstructed the star's light, leading to a noticeable dimming effect observed by astronomers on Earth. This dimming event lasted for several months, capturing the attention of backyard observers as well as professional astronomers. What made this event even more remarkable was the disruption it caused to Betelgeuse's regular pulsation cycle. For nearly two centuries, scientists had meticulously documented the star's pulsation rate, which occurred every 400 days. However, in the aftermath of the surface ejection, this pulsation rate ceased, at least temporarily. This unexpected disruption provided further evidence of the ferocity of the ejection event and its profound impact on Betelgeuse's internal dynamics. The behavior of Betelgeuse in the aftermath of the ejection puzzled scientists. It was postulated that the star's interior convection cells, which drive the regular pulsations, might be in disarray, resembling an imbalanced washing machine. Despite this internal turmoil, Hubble spectra and surface observations suggested that the outer layers of Betelgeuse may eventually return to a more stable state. However, the star's surface continued to exhibit erratic behavior, akin to a gelatin dessert quivering on a plate, as the photosphere rebuilt itself. Driven by a thirst for knowledge, scientists continued to explore Betelgeuse's mysteries using historical depictions and descriptions of the star from various cultures and time periods. Through careful analysis, they managed to pinpoint approximately when Betelgeuse acquired its distinctive red coloration. Around 2,000 years ago, the star transitioned from a yellow-orange hue to its current red appearance. The historical accounts provided fascinating insights into the life cycle of Betelgeuse and its evolutionary journey. Stars, particularly those more massive than our Sun, undergo color changes throughout their lifetimes as nuclear fusion consumes hydrogen in their cores. These changes in color are accompanied by variations in brightness and size, offering vital clues about a star's age and mass. Studying historical documents, the team discovered intriguing references to Betelgeuse's color. For instance, Chinese court astronomer Sima Qian, writing in 100 BCE, described Betelgeuse as having a yellow-orange hue, differentiating it from the white Sirius, the red Antares, and the blue Bellatrix. Similarly, Roman scholar Huygens, around 100 years later, likened Betelgeuse's color to that of Saturn, indicating a yellow-orange appearance during that time. In the 14th century, Ptolemy distinguished Betelgeuse from other red-colored bright stars like Antares. These historical accounts provided a fascinating glimpse into Betelgeuse's color evolution over the centuries. Despite many uncertainties, the ongoing observations and investigations continue to shed light on Betelgeuse's enigmatic behavior. Scientists are studying the star's deep dimming and its potential connection to merging cycles. The fact that anyone can observe Betelgeuse, even with smaller telescopes or the naked eye, adds to the excitement and engagement of the public in unraveling the mysteries of this celestial object. Betelgeuse's twin mysteries, the deep dimming and the strange gravitational wave detection, make it a fascinating subject of study. The star's behavior challenges our understanding of stellar evolution, and the ongoing research represents a new frontier in the making. It's a rare opportunity to witness a star like Betelgeuse, which has the power to captivate and inspire both scientists and the general public. What other secrets and surprises might Betelgeuse have in store for us? Like, share, comment, and watch more content like this here.